During the last 2 years, we saw the issuance of green bonds in many in the in at least a few countries in Asia, like Korea. We've seen it in China recently, and then we see it in Taiwan. I'm wondering, how do you see the prospects of a green bonds in Indonesia?
Well, the prospects are absolutely great, and we are sincerely hoping that the Tropical Landscapes Bond, given the kind of partners that have come together, which are world leaders in their own right, would actually throw up ideas and lessons that actually will draw green investment into Indonesia.
Yeah.
There's nothing exclusive about this. It's an idea whose time has come. And the more partners that can come to invest in Indonesia, it's a great opportunity for the people of Indonesia, but also for the people of the world. Because Indonesia, I mean, just to give you an example. Again, I don't want to scare anybody with numbers, but it's a scary number. In Paris, at COP21, one of the numbers that was being spoken about for per ton of carbon cost, you know, like a floor price for carbon, was 40 euros per ton. Indonesia emitted 1.6 gigatons of CO2 equivalent last year during the forest fires. So if you look at that, and if there was an arrangement where countries that put out things in the atmosphere, if there was a balance sheet, okay, you know, this is your entitlement, and if you put out more, you'll have to pay. That will be $64 billion to pay. So don't want to scare anybody, but these are facts that are in the public domain. Thankfully, there is no such arrangement at this time. But I'm sure as we go along, in a few years, these kind of arrangements would fall in place. When we are at the tipping point and everybody is looking at everybody's budget and what are you spending and how bad it is for the global order of things. So I think, you know, it's very important for Indonesia, but even more important for the world to come to Indonesia and invest in socially responsible ideas which can transform Indonesia and thereby help the world. So, you know, you cannot expect Indonesia to do the heavy lifting by itself. So the world has to put its money where its mouth is, and while we should expect Indonesia to do better in terms of environmental issues, we should also support Indonesia to do better.
All right. One final question, Satya. How can we increase the investor confidence in investing in green financing type deals?
I think the investor confidence can be increased by three things to me, because I speak a lot with the highest levels in the government, so I think, and also speak to the investors at the highest level. So I think these three things are very important. And I think the BKPM, the Investment Promotion Bureau, is doing quite an admirable job in that already. I think we need to talk to the investors and see where, like, you know, in our process, when we start talking, one of the issues that has come up in a big way is that this holding tax, withholding tax, you know?
Yeah.
Like, you're bringing in money, but before even anything is made, you know, some tax is being withheld, and how is that going to work? Because if you are going to try and give money, let's say, for example, at 50% the market rates to poor people, so you cannot be treated the same way as commercial investments. So there has to be some special regime which doesn't exist, right? So I think that's a sensitivity on the part of the government to look at everything not in numbers, but as a whole social compact. And what does the money do for our people and us, rather than just in numbers, just returns and numbers? That's a complicated thing to do, but a very important and very necessary thing to do. That's the first thing, on the government side. On the side of the investors, I think a greater willingness to take some risk, because, you know, as they say, no risk, no gain, all risk involves pain.
Yes.
So there will be some, we've run simulation models in different provinces in Indonesia, as well at a national basis. Last year, we launched something called the Forest Ecosystems Valuation Study. It's on the web, so I'll recommend you to look at it, which basically tells you that Indonesia's natural resource stocks are staggering. So if you go onto a green economy model, yes, for the first few years, you might see a little dip in your GDP. But then as it grows, your stocks will be your greatest assets. And then the returns actually far outstrip the conventional economic returns that we have seen through an extraction model. So a conservation model actually works better for Indonesia. And it's not just us, many other eminent scholars have done studies and pointed to that fact. So that's the second thing. And the third thing is for international organizations and other partners to come together and help create this social compact, where we just don't put money out there and expect the community to pay it back, because in many cases that capacity is lacking within communities to negotiate effectively and to use the resources gainfully in a proper manner, have the technical know-how, and then get the money back. Because the best thing that works is for an investor to come in, put the money, and the community to pay it back, gaining in the process. So then we would have created a true social compact that includes the government, the investors, and the community.
Yeah. Okay. All right. On that note, Satya, thank you very much indeed for the insightful views. And
thank you.
Let's give it a round of applause.